Hello, this is George Lees again, and I want to show you why I believe they have had the massive storms in Carolina in America this year week, and also they have had massive storms in the Philippines this very week. And you know already about the Philippines and the history of all the Christian denominations in that place, and they're still using the Piso currency in that place. Yeah, and that is the launch of Bonifacio and the launch of Thor's Oak and the massive religious scam that leads to false Christmas and everybody dropping the pagan gods as things that are worshipped by all of the pagan world. Yeah, I was going to play some music. And all of it is the same as the Robinson Crusoe slaving issues. And that is Man Friday. And the joke that you've got no women in those islands. So you have to make do with your man on a Friday. And all of it is the biggest piss take in world history, because the Pisos launched it all. Like the slaving ships, and I'm going to explain that now, that is the symbol for the Royal African Company on the top left there, and the title at the top is RAC Slaving Royals Charles II and Duke of York. Okay, so the naming of Charleston in America, which is in South Carolina, is the launch of Charles the First and Charles the Second, who launched, not the Royal Automobile Club, which is the cover on the right with the crown on it, but they launched the Royal African Slaving fucking Company. Yeah, as the elite family that are representatives for the papal lines that are Catholicism right up to Charles the First in Britain. Then he got executed by his parliament. Totally corrupted and total Muppet show ever since it was launched, and then he was replaced by Charles II, who was the first man to grow a pineapple. And the naming of the Royal Africa Company is the naming of the Royal Automobile Club, which we still have today. And the AA is the same joke as the Piso's launch for every letter in the world. And on it goes. And this is launched out of Elephant and Castle. And you can see on the badge, on the left, that the Elephant and Castle is part of the pistic. I hope you can see that in Rothschild yellow. Royal African Company. RAC Slaving Royals, Charles II and Duke of York. That is Sarah Ferguson's lines that we have profiled in great detail in recent days and shown how she is a terrorist in the New York Twin Towers scam, and how the whole of the bloodline, except her, is now on the Committee of 300 as the world's biggest thugs and richest people. Okay, so the storms have occurred in those places, and I'm now going to show you some of the magnitude of those issues. Here we go. So this is Tropical Storm Florence in Carolina, USA, September the 13th, 2018. And they get massive lightning storms. I forget what the statistics are, but I'll show you in later. In due course, if we get the time. So these are the gods that have been completely replaced, and this is what they have the power to do. And as you might have guessed now, this is one of the hubs and the places where the ports are for the slaving industry, and it was focused for the Royal British Company that ran it in Carolina. Yeah, Charlestown and or the Charlemagne serial killings that launch Christianity and replace the global pagans in Europe and all over the whole continent of the Americas. And strangely, there is the Piso pineapple. Yeah, and they do not see it coming. They do not believe in the gods that created them. Yeah, and all of the massive storms, unless they're created using the Hollywood technology, are all the same story. Right then, so, what's that one? Okay, this is the story of slaving. Carolina is the hub.
Suffered agony, disease, and death. In a living nightmare, each soul on board would see, hear, and smell the pain inflicted on others aboard. The ship's masters looked, spoke, and behaved like no one else these doomed passengers had ever seen. It was during this ghastly passage that the prisoners often lost their will to live. And if they found themselves alive by voyage's end, they were sold off as merchandise to the highest bidder in the New World. It was this odyssey through the gates of hell that forged a new people, without rights, without a voice, respect, or freedom. Slaves in America were introduced to the eternal truths of the Bible through their owners, but often with the aim of subduing any idea of rebellion. Some masters recited passages that reinforced their goals. Slaves, obey your masters, just as you would obey Christ. The lives of slaves were closely watched and regulated. They were not allowed free movement or speech, and therefore covertly forged a bond, language, and culture among each other. It is that bond and support that has permeated, enriched, and enhanced the Black faith experience to this day.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus.
So do you get the magnitude of it? Every one of those scams using the poor people of Africa, from Ghana, most of these in North and South Carolina, they are taught to believe in Jesus. And let me show you the doctrines that tell you that Carolina is named by the religious fraudsters that are the Pisos. Okay, there is the Royal African Company logo, and those royals are the British Protestants, British Catholics first. That was Charles the First. Then, when his head was taken off by the Parliament, they then launched the Rules of Jesus to create the Protestant son of that man and the growing of the first Pineappl for Piso in Britain. Yeah, that's the Royal African Company, and it's the cover, which is the Royal Automobile Club, which is the RAC. And there are the coins that are called Elephant and Castle, and it's run, all of it, by the House of Stuart, the British royal family. Take that with a pinch of salt, because James, the wee James, was taken into the Tudor dynasties, and he was forced to train with the English armies, and all he was kidnapped from the Bass Rock on the east coast of Scotland. And that is the O'Brien region for Archbishop O'Brien. Okay, and those products are gold, silver, ivory, and slaves. Do you get it? That is the British Royals, World Wildlife Fund, and the ivory enslaving system that they have run ever since it was launched in the name of Stuart, which suddenly becomes Tudor because the Stuarts never got a shot on the throne. Yeah? And that is Iacobus the Second. Yeah? And that will be Charles the Second. And there are the royal icons, which become the Rotary Club and the wagon wheels on the flip side of the coin. Okay? The Royal African Company was an English mercantile west coast of Africa trading system out of the city of London. It was led by the Duke of York, who was the brother of Charles II and later took the throne as James II. Wee James and his brothers. Its original purpose was to exploit the gold fields up the Gambia River, which were identified by Prince Rupert, and Canada is now Rupert's Land for a laugh. During the interregnum, Charles II gained the English throne in the Restoration of 1660. However, it was soon engaged in the slave trade as well as with other commodities. It mainly traded with the Gold Coast, which is now Ghana. And there are its tools. And you've seen the pictures of the poor people compressed into those slaving ships, and everybody knows that story. Okay, and there's a list of notable investors. Charles II of England, James Stuart, Duke of York, governor of the RAC from its creation, and the largest shareholder, Hannah Rothschild. John Locke, and all of the stories about Locke, the Irish singer, being a tax evader. Anthony Ashley Cooper, first Earl of Shaftesbury. Sir Raymond Clayton, Sir Edmund Andros, Henry Bennett, Earl of Arlington, which is the massive cemetery in America for all their war dead, and JFK. George Villiers, Lord Buckingham, that's the de Villiers dynasties of South Africa and the Republic, yeah, which are right back in ancient Rome, and all of the places that are named after the Praetorian Guard there, yeah. Sir George Carteret, Earl of Craven, and once again the Cravens of the Morgan Grenfell Banking Group and the Deutsche Bank come into the story. Lawrence Dupuy, Ferdinand Gorges, Lord Francis Holly, Thomas Povey, Prince Rupert of Canada, yeah, Sir Joseph Williamson, Matthew Wren, Sir Peter Colliton, Sir John Banks, Sir Joshua Childhar. Yeah. The major notable investors in the Royal Africa Company. It was dissolved by the African Company Act 1750, with its assets being transferred to the African Company of Merchants. These principally consisted of 9 trading posts known as factories for slaves: Fort William, Fort James, Fort Secundi, Fort Winneba, Fort Apollonia, and that's all of the romantic classical music about the Apollonian Mountains, Fort Tancumberry, Quarry, Fort Metal Cross, Fort Commenda, and Cape Coast Castle, which was the administrative centre. Okay? And there is a subsidiary, sometimes known as the Gambian Merchants Company. And everywhere you have companies, you have Quislings selling their people. And that is the role of Pocahontas, who is in London selling real estate. Yeah? And that's why she got into the museum movie. Because she is the tribe that allowed the pilgrims to survive through that first harsh winter. So, the storms were quite dramatic, and let me remind you of that. There is the forecast, and there's Donald Trump looking ever so concerned about the fate of his nation, and his dad's middle name was Christ. That's Fred Christ Trump, and all of them, including his dad and his granddad, ran brothels in the places where the pagan wealth was being ripped out in the form of gold and diamonds. And that is the brothels he ran in the Yukon Gold Rush. Yeah, and there it is, lashing the Carolinas. Let me show you the Piso joke now. Yeah, and there is them being launched into the Piso Bible doctrine that has happened in the Philippines too, and all of them become evangelists for the God that never lived, and none of them now worship the sun god Sol Natalis Invictus, whose day of celebration, yeah, was not in those churches. It was under the beautifully sunlit places that the pagans lived in, or just outside their caves, or their tents, yeah, or their, I forget what the Indian tent is, their, yeah, it's a pyramidal shape like the rest of the joke for religion. Yeah, that's the McAlpine dynasty that is the earliest Piso popes, and it is Lord McAlpine, sadly. And all the residual politicians that they have in the movie making sector, and even in the Scottish government, right up to the present day. So, let me just show you the Piso bit on my OneNote profile. So there is the history of South Carolina. And all of it is the Piso piss take. Okay. South Carolina is named in honour of King Charles I of England, who was beheaded because he was a Catholic, who first formed the English colony, with Carolus being Latin for Charles. Do you get it? That is Oliver Cromwell, the taking over with sectarian beliefs of the whole of Ireland, and all of the troubles ever since that happened, with the help of the German serial killers and the Dutch ones that were William and Mary, that were gifted a house which is actually a palace called Blenheim, because they are the people that won, in the form of William and Mary of Orange, the launch of Protestantism in all of these troubled places. And that is what they call God, and the God that they worship never lived, and in Deuteronomy, in that Bible, even the black people who were not educated would be taught that worshipping a false icon, aka a human, is not allowed in the original Bibles that were written. That is Deuteronomy, and even the Monty Python's billionaire team know that joke. Okay, Charles I of England, who was executed as a Catholic, and his son, and all of them become trainees in the English Tudor dynasty that murders all of its women because they cannot have male children because they've got a female gene in them. And that is all of Henry VIII's wives, and he's a massive mobster like the Pope, and all of them are charging for the rental of God's land all over the world, which is why many of them have horrible deaths. Right then, let me show you the English-speaking people's jokes about the naming of the place that it is. Yet, usual suspects, the motto is Dum Spiro Spero. Yeah, that has got the word Piso in it, and it's got the word Peso in it twice. Okay, that is the peso currency that they still use in Mexico, that they still use in flooded Philippines, and that is the peso author of the Bible's nickname, twice presented there in that anagram. Dum Spiro Spero, and Spiro Agnew was one of their dumb politicians, because all you need to get a political salary is to be a Muppet. And you're better than that, Shona Robinson, and I have great faith in you to bring the world back to justice and to make your formerly NHS patients safe in Scotland under logical and safe medical regimes. I hope that is why you resigned, because that is the Piso joke too. And that is the launch of statins as toxic drugs when all of your hypertensive patients get to the age of 60. And 60 is the Piso code number, like the one I told you about in the earlier videos on the great escape of the world's fascists to all of the other countries across the world that they do not already own. Yeah, that is Piso code for the 50 that were lined up at the back of the truck in the Great Escape movie. 50 means nothing, and 60 means Arius Copernicus Piso, or the Father God, or Jesus, all of which were the names of the fake Bible author. And Jesus never lived when he was alive, and Jesus never lived ever, because that is the launch of Xmas. And X is on his birth certificate, and that is Exeter, Exmouth, and Devon, where Exeter is, and that is heaven in the joke. Okay, do you get it? Dum Spiro Spero. And that means, while I breathe, I hope. Yeah, that's the Piso and Peso pessimists, because they know that there is a God, and they know that that God determines how long they get to live and which pathologies they get, depending on whether or not they use the nicknames for that Bible author in their names. Yeah, and that is why some of them get polio, and some of them get horrible illnesses, and some of them just get minor illnesses with the word Piso in it, like what is the itchy, scratching disease that you get on your skin? Psoriasis. If the word is in the name, yeah, the man's name is in the pathology and the descriptor for the pathology, then the families that use that name are likely to get it. And it's really dangerous to make your political and your geographical and your land-enhancing policies based on the world's most evil people. But that's what America and Britain and all of the German-speaking nations have done so that they can become the world owners. Sorry, Austria is not necessarily the same as Germany, but they're all in the same team, which is why Australia was named Australia. The austere, ancestry of the world's fascists. Animos opibusc parati, that's a Latin version, and it means prepared in mind and resources. And the state songs are Carolina, and that is the Carolinian lineage that came after the Merovingians, and all of it is centuries old, and that is the centuries old Coldplay scams, and on it goes. Right then, I think we may stop there. Have I shown you the storms? Okay, there's the slaves, let's finish it.
There is power in the name of Jesus to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Woo! To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
And they, to do them justice, have no choice. They are chained to the boat. They go down with the boat if it sinks. And that is all of the conscripts to all of the great wars, that all of the same family that are descended from Piso and the Queen of England and King Herod, all of them are fascists, and they are the biggest cause of death in world history. Of Gladstone and all the ethnic hatred, and he is a slavery prime minister in England. And that's the Coolies, how Britain reinvented slavery, tells the astonishing and controversial story of the systematic recruitment and migration of all the world's peoples against their will. And that goes on right at the beginning of the Bible. And that is the launch of Judah into the slaving ships for Egypt. Isn't it hilarious? And that is Charlton Heston, that at least has the wits to see that it is a tragedy for the world that the Empire State ends up as the Empire State statue on the beach, almost covered by the ocean already. It is absolutely pathetic. And that is the launch of the RAC. And I should really look up who the owners of the RAC is and the founders are, but do you get it? Royal African Company and the Royal Automobile Company and the Elephant and Castle. For Princess Anne and the murderous royals that shoot the elephants and shoot the rhinos and shoot the rare species, because they are becoming the rarest species in the world, because the gods are now fighting a Star Wars war against them, and they are losing badly and bleeding. from every available vent. Okay, and there is the other images, and there is the launch, and there are the coins for the Rotary Club, and it's all the same joke as Jesus' cross, as always, and the swastika, yeah, and the Piso Polis are named after them, and there are their handcuffs. I think I should maybe stop there now, in case we get into deep water. And that is very easy for the gods to do to us. Yeah? And they've got a little bit of land on the outside of America, which reflects the fact that the whole of it is subject to seismic earthquakes. And I forget what they call that land. It may be biblical in nature, and that's God's work too. And he's the victim of it, because the bill for his acts of God are bigger, even although he's only been in power for 18 months to 2 years, are bigger than any other regime have ever had before him, because he's totally evil, and he's from Germany, like all of the world's banksters and the mobsters that conducted the Shin, that took the federal banks over in every country in the world, and they will not release the identity of their directors. Yeah, and that is in a free capitalist, a free democratic environment that is now prevalent over the whole world, but all of the banking rules that it must continue to be owned by Rothschild, Jacob Schiff, yeah, and all of those names that participated in the Shin with George W. Bush's regime, and they launched World War I under the pretense that they launched the federal banks, making a unanimous decision when only three people showed up in the Parliament building under Woodrow Wilson's thrall, and Woodrow Wilson's women are the people that get deceived, because he was coerced into launching World War One by being discovered in an affair, Shona Robinson. Yeah, and you can change the world if you have the wits and you have the courage. Yeah, and I've seen your Muppet Show, and all of them are Muppets, and that is the diversion and the laughing at Scottish history that is the Widows of Culloden. And you're not allowed to take pictures of the Widows of Culloden, because that would not be politically correct, like the whole of everybody's lives in the Muppet team. Right then, I think we should just show you a brief picture of the Philippine storms. Uh, 2018. Yes, this is where they still use the Piso currency. Typhoon Mangkhut, and this is the Manco Buck story for the bloodlines that go right back into Austro-Hungaria. And this is in the Philippines and all of the empires that Spain and Portugal have all over the oceanic world. And it's quite melodramatic, really. Typhoon Mangkhut kills dozens in the Philippines, pounds South China. Typhoon Mangkhut slams China in the Philippines. Okay, let's just have a look.
It is the world's strongest storm so far this year, and tonight, Mangkhut continues its deadly sweep, slamming into Hong Kong before making landfall in southern China. Fierce winds smashed windows and brought down trees in Hong Kong. The wind speeds reaching up to 170 kilometers an hour, with damaging effects, causing this crane to collapse and sending debris like this couch flying down the streets. Officials warn people to stay away from the waterfront, and you can see why. In some areas, the storm surge reached more than 3 meters. And this was the scene in southern China as the typhoon hit the mainland. At least two people were killed when it made landfall in Guangdong province. More than 2.4 million people have been forced from their homes. Mangkhut has left a path of destruction in its wake. On Saturday, the Philippines took a direct hit. More than 60 people were killed. The typhoon slamming into Luzon, the country's biggest and most populous island, with winds of up to 190 kilometers an hour. It's where the CBC's Asia correspondent, Sasha Petrasik, is reporting for us tonight.
It's only now that rescuers, road crews, and reporters are reaching places like this, remote canyons where yesterday's massive storm brought landslides and waterfalls that just won't stop, where the cleanup has barely started. Along the Buet River, for instance, in the mountains north of Manila, simple houses here cling to steep sides. The people who live in them cling to a meager existence. Typhoon Mangkhut took most of it away from David Pagsong. Today, an aid worker has come to offer some basic supplies to help his family. Water, food, toothbrushes. A few mountaintops away, things are looking more grim after reports that a group of gold miners, perhaps several dozen, were caught in a massive landslide.
First Pineappl in England. Just to show you that it's me, it is me, and that is the menagerie of Piso nicknames that is now coming up under the Dear Jesse song for Madonna. Yeah, I'm not going to play it in case we get copyrighted. That's the sun god who has now been replaced by Madonna herself as the mother of God and the Virgin. And on it goes, and all of his nicknames are still used by people like St. Nicholas Sturgeon. Yeah, and on they go as gods of war and all of the natural acts that have frightened Donald so much, he knows exactly what he needs to do to end it and proclaim that the Jesus never lived. And that is all of his Austro-Hungarian marriages and the launch of the demonization of other religions after Christianity has proven to be the biggest cause of death and the biggest fake joke for religion that ever existed. And those sun gods are still up there and they create every one of those weather storms. Yeah, and Christmas is coming. Yeah, and the goose is getting cooked. And all of it is that Austrian master race joke. And the goose stepping that Donald now contests that the Koreans have the right to do. And all of it is the same joke through world history. And it's absolutely lethal. And they have completely written the gods that look after us, that create the absolutely necessary weather patterns that allow you to have bountiful harvests and peaceful lives without having to build your house again several times in your lifetime if you're totally evil and you're dedicated to the launch and the preaching of that religion for the God that never lived. Bye. Oh, sorry. Just to let me show that it's us. Okay? And that is an anagram for Taranis, and that is one of the earliest gods of annihilation in Holland, where many of the American presidents came from, making the joke about Delaney's donkey, and that is the Roosevelt and Bush bloodlines, and all of them are fascists, and all of them have attempted deliberately to take over the world by violence and launching wars in the name of Jesus. Yeah, and the Christian nations, and the battles are now fought against Islam ever since we went to the Nile River confluence, that is the Mad Mahdi's fighting against the Shakespearean actors, yeah, at Khartoum. Yeah, it is a massive set of massacres so the royals can stay in power, and that is why that concept there, that the royals are running the slavery trade, is absolutely abysmal, and I wanted you to know it, because that stunned me when I learned it yesterday. And we were not members of the RAC, because it's toffee-nosed and posh John Patterson. Are you now getting the jokes about the limousines going to Brighton? And there is the coat of arms for the Royal African Company. Bye.